Hey everybody, Jessica McNair here with Storytime Shuttle. You can find me on Facebook and YouTube at Storytime Shuttle, and also you can shop my shopping link at www.storytimeshuttle.com. So if you're watching this video, you are most likely either considering signing up and joining this summer's Summer Reading Challenge, or you've already signed up, which is awesome. Either way, I'm so excited. And the point of this video is real quick, just to give you guys a couple of ideas on finding the sponsors that your little one or ones will need to help them reach their goal, you know, give them a little bit of incentive, and then also give them those free books at the end of summer. So keep in mind, the Summer Reading Challenge is a pledge-based challenge, right? So we basically need a little team of sponsors, friends, family members, mentors to rally around your little reader and encourage them to meet their goal of 20 minutes for 20 days, right? So there are several practical, easy ways to do this. I think a lot of people think, oh, sponsors, I'm not doing that. Well, don't let the sponsor part of it hold you back from enjoying and participating in the Summer Reading Challenge, okay? Plus, thankfully, 65% of Usborne books are $10 or less. So I guarantee you we can find some books, okay? So let's look at a couple of different ways that we could find sponsors. The first, probably the most popular, is the 10-10 challenge, right? Consider finding 10 people to donate $10. Easy peasy. So if that happens, then we've got $100 to spend on those free books at the end of our summer reading challenge. So it may be that you don't find 10. Let's say we only find 5 people to give us those 10 reward dollars for meeting the summer reading challenge. Well, then that's $50, okay? So don't get overwhelmed by, oh, I've got to have this many numbers or this many dollars or whatever. And they may not even commit to $10. They may commit to $5 or whatever it may be. Also, too, I'm kind of basing that on a flat rate, which seems the simplest to me, but there's plenty of ways to do it. So if your sponsor didn't necessarily want to do a flat rate, you know, it just depends on how in-depth you want to be with it. They could pay like a dime per minute, or they could pay, say, $2 for every 20 minutes that your little reader spends reading, right? So there's a lot of different ways we could break that up. But just as a starter, think of 10-10, the 10-10 challenge, okay? We want to try and find 10 sponsors for our reader to pay them $10 at the end of their challenge, okay? The next suggestion that I would have in finding sponsors would be, seems pretty obvious, to hit up the grandparents. Sorry, that's terrible, isn't it? But the grandparents... if there's a favorite aunt or uncle or a mentor that you guys spend a lot of time with, or that your little one is just in love with, then definitely that would be a great person to help encourage them and to give them that extra incentive. And how excited would they be to help them do that, right? And to be considered to be a sponsor. So let's look at within our little realm of people and hit up the grandparents, first of all. I feel so guilty saying that. I don't know why, but anyways. Okay, then suggestion number 3 would be to let your little ones donate. Having the sponsors know that your little one is considering giving back part of what they are getting is a great way to draw attention, I guess, and let the little one, first of all, participate, but also communicate to the sponsors what their intentions are. So you could have little one kind of announce or tell friends or family member or whatever that they are going to donate 25% of their books that they earn at the end of the challenge to, say, a church program or a children's hospital or school, some other type of ministry, even the Downtown Rescue Mission in Huntsville. They've got a children's reading room that would be beyond excited to receive 25% of your children's books that they earn at the end of the summer. So that's just a suggestion to let them communicate to those who are there considering as sponsors that they are also willing to give back part of what they receive as a reward. But the next suggestion I have would be to make a video. Who doesn't like to watch all these cute little kids telling about the reading challenge this summer and asking for sponsors? It doesn't have to be any lengthy ordeal, nothing fancy. You can hold up your phone and say, go kids, and then let them explain that they are reading this summer. They have decided to join a reading challenge, that they want to read 20 minutes for 20 days, and they want some people to help them earn free books at the end of summer. Simple as that. Then have them hold up a drawing or a picture. You can always write a little note saying, please sponsor me this summer in my reading challenge. Take a picture, post it on there. But either way you do it, please don't let this hold you back from enjoying and participating in the summer reading challenge. Remember, we've got two sessions. The first one will start May 21st, and you can even join that beyond May 21st, obviously, but that's when we'll officially kick it off. And then the other one will run the month of July. So I'm so excited. I can't wait to hear what other ideas you guys might have. Feel free to post them in the comments there. And then I'll also post the drop form so that you can register as well if you haven't done so already. So excited for you guys. Can't wait to participate with everybody this summer in the Summer Reading Challenge.